sponsors, distinguished guests, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome on behalf of the Australian National Centre for Latin American Studies here at the ANU and the Embassy of Paraguay to this event, a performance of the Paraguayan harp by the international artist Mariano Gonzalez. I'm John Minns, the director of ANCLIS here at the ANU, and we are very pleased tonight to be able to help in bringing people such as Mariano to Canberra and to Australian audiences to sample a small part of what is an amazingly diverse and amazing part of the culture of Latin America. And it's extremely fitting that we're able to bring this performance to you this evening because today is actually the National Day of Paraguay as well. To say a few words about that and also to introduce our guest performer tonight, I have the great pleasure to present the chargé d'affaires of the Embassy of Paraguay in Australia, Mr. Esteban Bedoya.
Thank you very much, John. Mr. Ross Westcott, Deputy Chief of Protocol, Your Excellencies, Member of Diplomatic Corps, ladies and gentlemen. I'm both proud and pleased to have the honor to celebrate the 201st anniversary of Paraguay independence, and also to celebrate our 9th month since the opening of the Paraguayan Embassy in Canberra. Today, as always, Paraguay's people are optimistic. We have a long history as a nation, which encourages us to be positive toward the future. The conquerors of vast territories in South America departed from Paraguay, and Paraguayan Creoles founded cities in Bolivia and Argentina, including Buenos Aires, during the 16th century. Once, Paraguay was the economic vanguard of South America and a leader in obtaining rights for citizens. But tragic events in past centuries relegated us to an extreme situation of weakness. However, Paraguay overcame the world's hardships through a sense of community based on the strength of a national culture rooted in the Spanish Guaraní heritage. Paraguay is a bilingual nation with a very strong identity reflected, for example, through our popular music. And in our popular music, the Paraguayan harp is a cultural emblem, which represents not only the nation of Paraguay and its traditions, but also the ideals that contribute to a collective notion of Paraguayanness. It is a touchstone for Paraguayans' pride in our national territory, our collective historical memory, our Guaraní-Spanish bilingual reality, the landmarks of our natural environment, and the rich legacy of our folk traditions. The melodies, harmonies, rhythms, lyrics, and even song titles associated with our music evoke in Paraguayan listeners notions of self-identity. Present-day Paraguayan harps are a local adaptation of the instrument brought from Europe by Jesuit missionaries during the 17th and 18th centuries. The creation of Paraguayan folk music is promotion in international festivals, the recording and radio and television broadcasts, the systematic instruction of the harp in conservatories and schools, and the image, sound, and virtuosity of the instrument have contributed to the standing of the Paraguayan harp as one of the most renowned and iconic of Latin American folk music traditions. Since 2007, the World Harp Festival takes place every year in Asunción, where harps from around the world are presented, from Ireland, Senegal, Japan, Mexico, Venezuela, Germany, France, etc. Since that year, Paraguay has made a submission to UNESCO for recognition of Asunción as the World Harp Capital. But Paraguayan folklore and our national tradition are not the only product of the Hispano-Guarani cultural component. Due to its substantial immigration, Paraguay is a melting pot with migrants mainly from Europe, but also from Arab countries and from other regions. Among these immigrants were Australians, who in the late 19th century created two colonies in the jungles of Paraguay, New Australia and Cosme. In these colonies, dreams of a just society were built through the efforts and humanistic inspiration of many Australians, including William Lane and Mary Gilmore. Mary Gilmore was one of the great Australian poets whose image can be seen on the $10 banknote used every day by Australians. This poet became a teacher in the Paraguayan countryside. We are pleased to keep working to strengthen the century-old relationship between our peoples, a relationship that for sure will continue to bear fruit, just like those Aussies in my country in the late 19th century, and like the Paraguayans who found the doors open to them in Australia so they could achieve a life of opportunities. Finally, on behalf of Paraguay and the Paraguayan people, I'm very pleased to offer this concert to the Queen and to the people of Australia. Thank you very much. And now I will introduce to Mariano Gonzalez. Mariano, please.
Thank you. Muchísimas gracias. Muy buenas tardes, más bien buenas noches para toda la audiencia, distinguida audiencia. Es un honor muy grande para mí estar aquí en este Great Hall de la universidad. Cumpliendo una misión muy importante para mí, representar la música paraguaya en ocasiones como esto, realmente es un honor muy grande. Muchas gracias, señor embajador, por traerme hasta aquí. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My English is not so good. I try hard, but every day I try hard. Anyway, it's a great honor for me to be here at this great hall, famous university. Really, I'm very pleased to be here. Long time I love this country. When I was young, I was watching the TV, watching the favorite program, watching the animal world. Australia is my favorite, always, until now. And now I'm lucky to be here, and I'm still looking for the koala and kangaroo. Now, yeah. I'm looking for this, really. Pretty soon, my friend will take me, so my dream will come true. Anyway, I have to tell you something. My English, of course, I am Paraguayan originally. When I was young, I go to Japan. I went to Japan for a long, long time. I live in Japan. And I learned English in Japan. So my English is Japanese accent. It's perfect Japanese anyway. Everybody confused me everywhere. Are you Japanese? They say to me. But what can I do? Well, thank you very much. Anyway, I have some on the line of a program here. The second one, I'm going to say this a little bit switch. For another song, considering today is a Paraguayan Independence Day, so one is this song is very popular, especially for some traditional event. So this song always they play around there. So I would like to play to all of you this beautiful song. It's a march. Look like a polka, but not a polka. It's a more traditional. Lever is a march. So please listen, it's called Chaco Boreal.
Thank you.
thank you so much. The next song is a very meaningful name. It's a Paraguayan dance, danza paraguaya. Particular, this song, we owe a lot to this Australian world best guitar player, John Williams. He selected this song to promote around the world. Agustin Barrio is one of the greatest composers from Paraguay. And John Williams took the advantage to introduce to the world. So I'd like to thanks. I hope maybe sometime personally I can greet this, my favorite guitar player in the world, John Williams. So he played this song. Of course, I'm going to do a transcription for the harp. Look like a harp, I mean guitar too. And then the various pieces is not so easy for the harp. But I try my best to play today. Gracias. Next, I think that my manager, the president of association, Paraguayan Association, said, he told me, Mariano, don't talk too much. Your English, nobody understands you. Go ahead and play. That's what he told me. So I have to speak less. And I play more, I guess. The next two songs I have to announce is the most romantic Paraguayan folk song we call Guaranias. Guarania is a rhythm, like a waltz, let's say another bolero, or cha-cha-cha, any other rhythm name called the Guarania is original Paraguayan music rhythm. So these are two songs here. I have Recuerdos de Ipacaraí and Miss Noches in Tea. So I will play a medley for you. Muchas gracias. El pájaro chogui es un compositor argentino, muy famoso mundialmente este tema, grabó grandes músicos, grandes artistas, a nivel así de Julio Iglesias inclusive. Entonces, voy a interpretar El pájaro se vuelve. El siguiente es una música casi onomatopéyico. Es una música compuesta por un arpista muy famoso, Félix Pérez Cardoso. The next piece is a special rhythm for the harp. It's a great composer, harp player from Paraguay, Félix Pérez Cardoso, inspired from one of these all-time train, like a steam train, they call it milk train, yeah, milk train. Well, milk, anyway, they call it a tren lechero. Try to imitate this train sound of the harp. Well, not exactly anyway, but try to make a noise like a train anyway. Okay, please listen.
Thank you.
If you don't mind, I want to take my Australian water. That's pure water, yes. This is not the tequila, anyway. No, this is pure water. Excuse me. Oh, delicious. Well, maybe you're getting tired listening only. Okay, let me see. The next song is it's the most famous tango piece, La Comparsita. So, La Comparsita is a beautiful tango. Muchísimas gracias. Well, quite busy. You know, this is, I have to tell you something. The Paraguayan harp, we never have this lever on the harp. This is my own design Paraguayan harp. So under study, I mean, I had to learn every day to have to control this. Instead of the pedal, I have to do it with my hands. So keeping me busy. Sometimes you forget. Every the sound is spoiled, so almost happened with this sound to me. Very strongly had to control. Anyway, about this next song, I would like to everybody know this beautiful piece, El Condor Pasa. This and the music, is including everywhere we can hear this music. El Condor Pasa is one of the most prayer song, Latin song, I guess, ever, because I've been around the world and that I can hear in any language sang this song. Okay, see. Muchas gracias. I have one more song, I guess. One more? Yeah. The next one is Chile. Ah, this is El Condor Pasa from Peru. The next is a Chile song. ¿Pero? ¿Otra vez? Sí, claro que sí. Yo vendo unos ojos negros, tonada de Chile. Es muy lindo. Claro que sí. Thank you. Coffee time. This is Moliendo Café. This is from Venezuela. This Moliendo Café is very rhythmic. And I hope you help me too, to get the tempo, because it's very rhythmic. So if I feel alone, I mean, like if I play alone, I will miss your help. Like this. Okay. Like this. One. Vamos. Everybody, please. Yep. Yep. Sí. Vamos, sí. Wonderful, thank you for helping me. I just... Señor, encore. Otra vez, sí, claro que sí. I just want to offer and dance the beautiful song I just learned. And I'd like to share with you this beautiful Australia, a main song called Waltz in Mathilde. Yeah. This is not in the program, so I would like to. I just want to share with you this beautiful song called La Malagueña. Thank you. Thank you so much. My first time anchor song. Thank you so much. Well, if you have any requests like it, I heard. Pájaro Campana. Oh my God. Pájaro Campana. Ya no puede volar más porque ya no tiene pluma. Le falta pluma ya. De tanto campanazo, ¿eh? Con mucho gusto voy a interpretar. El pájaro campana es el himno del arpa paraguaya. Thank you. Muchas gracias. Amable. Muchísimas gracias. Amable, gracias, gracias, gracias.
Thank you very much, Mariano. Thank you. Thank you, John. And we'll enjoy a refreshment offered by the Anclas. Thank you again, John. And please, we will share all together. Thank you.